Kinder Franchise School.
Because I'm not a mighty tip.
Hope that was on film, because that was amazing.
Several years ago, a woman named Lauren Faust created one of the most popular television shows today for children called My Little Pony. And she very obviously drew inspiration from Deadpool when she wrote Pinkie Pie. Pinkie Pie breaks the fourth wall. There was an episode about Chimichurri Chongas. In one episode, she dresses up in a Pinkie Pie suit as herself. It's incredible. How do you feel about the fact that a writer who created a show for originally intended for little girls has made Deadpool basically a child-friendly version of it?
I love her and I hate her. Same thing I say to parents who tell me they brought their 7-year-old to go see the Deadpool. They're either the best parent in the world or the worst parent in the world. I don't know which. Hi.
Alright, so most likely going to be a sequel for Deadpool, with how awesome it is. With Deadpool and Cable, what kind of villain do you want to see Deadpool and Cable be up against in the sequel?
I actually want Cable to be the antagonist in the Deadpool movie, or vice versa. I want to see them go head to head first before they come together later on.
Preferably before the 2-hour mark, like another movie.
Yes.
Well, somebody before saw the 2-hour mark, if you like the other movie.
Yeah, I'm with that. I agree with that. Like, I would rather. Yeah, then just share the screen together.
They're breaking the story down now, and they have a lot of work to do because not only is a sequel usually harder to do than the first movie, because the first movie has a structure laid out for you already, just through the origin, but they also have a harder job because the movie is intended to serve as a launching platform for an X-Force franchise, right? That doesn't mean that, you know, hopefully they do it elegantly, and I have confidence that they will, because I think Paul and Rhett are excellent writers, and they were before they wrote the screenplay. I hope, and if I get a chance to talk to the guys before they do it, now they're the guys, just as we've talked after the movie, before they weren't the guys, now they're the guys. I feel that the reason the Deadpool movie resonated as well as it did, to the levels that it did, has nothing to do with how funny Deadpool is, or how rude the movie was, or how unexpected. All of those things are parts of it. The reason I think it was so broad and expanded is because it took a very simple story structure and made it work in an insane world. And that story structure is a Hugh Grant, Julia Roberts movie. The story is boy meets girl, boy loses girl, boy gets girl again. That's the structure of the Deadpool movie. And it works flawlessly, and it makes you leave the theater feeling good. And when you leave a theater feeling good, like another movie I'll watch eventually, you tell other people about it, which exponentially expands your audience, and that's what Deadpool did. So I would say to the guys that if you're doing Deadpool 2, and you're gonna have Cable in it, do not abandon the strength of the structure that you had in this story. Just change it on its ear a little bit. This story is boy meets boy, boy loses, boy back again. And to this movie, you have something that everyone leaves the theater feeling good about, and they can't wait to see X-Force number one. There you go.
And we have just like 3 minutes left, so I'm gonna get through these 3 questions.